Chapter 2, Desert Spirituality. Amasyncletica said, "Salvation is exactly this, the twofold love of God and of our neighbor." Sarah, Theodora, Syncletica, Matrona. These names of the desert Amas are hardly familiar to us. In the culture of Oprah and Elle, the desert mothers may seem so remote that their lives can't speak to yours. Yet each of the desert mothers, both those whose names we know and the many whose names are lost to us, offer us examples of women choosing to live as genuinely and as faithfully as possible. In each case, their culture and their families had expectations for what a woman's life should look like. The lives of the desert mothers are remarkable primarily for the Amas' ability to offer their lives back to God. This offering took different forms. Some lived by themselves. Others joined communities of women. Others were the heads of their women's communities. Still others became respected teachers of the Christian path. Some came from privileged and wealthy backgrounds, while others had been prostitutes. Some grew up as Christians. Some came to the desert while still not sure about the life of faith. For each of these women, the life of faith became a weaving together of love of God and love of neighbor, a choosing to live out the great commandment. Each woman's history also included a time of unease with what was expected of her, a moment of recognizing that what the living God might be calling her to be and to do was at variance with the various roles her family and her culture had to offer. When we recognize someone or something, we know again. Re, meaning again, and cognize, to know. When we recognize ourselves, we remember who we are called to be. We see again that our lives are offered to us as gifts, and that what we do with those lives, how we live every day, is important. By practicing this openness to recognizing both our faults and our deeper call to live authentically in Christ, we learn from the desert mothers. We become more honest with ourselves and with God. We take the time to reflect on our lives. We go back to the basics.